By Faraday's law, we know that whenever there is a change of flux linked to a coil, an EMF is induced in the coil. In the features of self-inductance, we have seen that the flux links to the coil. Who is responsible for flux? That coil itself. That is a different method. But a flux is being linked to a coil, so an induced EMF is produced in that. So if this is a coil and flux is linked to it, and this flux keeps on changing, who is changing this flux? Flux is B into A. Magnetic field, who is creating magnetic field? Current in the coil, mu naught Ni is the magnetic field produced by this multiplied by A. So who is responsible for the magnetic field? This current. And this current is flowing in it. And because of this current, this B is produced. Then B into A makes the flux. Now if there is any change in I, there will be change in B. If there is any change in B, there will be change in flux. And if there is any change in flux, d phi during such a time dt, then d phi by dt, what is this? EMF is induced. So there is one EMF which is flowing this current here, but due to change in this current, an opposite EMF is created. Now here a coil is connected with a circuit source of EMF and we switch it on. The moment we switch it on, a current flows in it. When a current flows in it, this makes a magnetic field. That magnetic field links with it, that makes a flux. The current, when there was no flow of current, the current was zero, and the moment we switch it on, the current rise and go to its maximum value I. From 0 to I. There is a change in current, there will be change in flux, and due to change in flux, an EMF is induced. And that EMF, according to Faraday's second law, is minus d phi by dt. Now this phi, in the previous lecture you have seen that phi is equal to L into I. This is coefficient of self-inductance, this we introduce here. So this is d by dt of L into I, and therefore, we can write it, E is equal to minus L di by dt. Di by dt is what? Rate of change of current. Di by dt is rate of change of current. Now suppose in a coil there is a current of 20 ampere flowing, and when we switch it off, this becomes 0 ampere and this takes a time of 0.5 second. What is di by dt? Answer, di is equal to 0 minus 20, dt is equal to 0.5. so di by dt is equal to minus 40 ampere per second. This is example of di by dt. More is the value of di, more will be EMF. Less is dt, more is EMF. So this is induced EMF which is across this coil. So this is EMF induced across a coil. Now we can define again this self-inductance with help of this E. How much is L here? L is equal to E divided by di by dt. Okay, in magnitude, and let's leave aside the direction. So L is equal to EMF induced divided by di by dt. Now, if I make this di by dt equal to 1, if di by dt is equal to 1 ampere per second, then L is equal to E. What is E? Induced EMF. Now we get another definition of coefficient of self-inductance. Coefficient of self-inductance is equal to induced EMF across a coil, because EMF or the voltage is a physical quantity we can measure. Current we can measure, time we can measure. So in a coil we take a change of current of the rate 1 ampere per second. Then whatever is the EMF induced, that will be numerically equal to self-inductance. Okay, we have a coil here. In this coil, the current is 5 ampere. Okay, current is 0, we make it 5 ampere and we take 5 seconds by raising it. So current was 0 ampere, slowly we increase the current to 5 ampere in 5 seconds. What is the rate of change of current? 5 ampere in 5 seconds, that is 1 ampere per second. 1 ampere per second. Then what we see across the ends of this coil, a voltage is generated. We measure that voltage. That voltage is 40 volt. 40 volt is generated. If this is 40 volt generated, we say this coil has self-inductance of 40 Henry. Okay, we take another coil. More numbers, more so. Again, we give it that variable current, 1 ampere per second. And during that change, 1 ampere per second change, we measure the voltage here. This voltage is 100 volt. We say this is a good coil. It has got self-inductance equal to 100 Henry. Okay. Then we take another coil. Many number of turns over here. And here again we apply 1 ampere per second change of the current and we measure the voltage here and we find it is 1000 volt. We say the self-inductance of this coil is 1000 Henry. So self-inductance is measured by the EMF induced when we are making the rate of change of current as 1 ampere per second. This is definition of self-inductance. Okay, and this is Henry. So in next lecture we will see what will be the direction of this EMF and how this affects electric current. Thank you.